For 7-year-old Gage, the shooting spree on Tuesday by a gunman in Northern California that left 5 people dead was yet another tragedy in his young life. When he was just 22 months old, his mother Cher was killed in an accident. When Kevin Jansen Neal, 44, began what authorities described as a murderous rampage in a neighborhood in Tehama County about 130 miles north of Sacramento, his father, his father's girlfriend and her mother were among the victims. His surviving grandmother, Sissy Fiedelberg, has now started a GoFundMe fundraising account to raise money to raise her grandson, now an orphan. My husband and I live on Social Security and a small retirement. I am going to have many, many expenses where Gage is concerned, she wrote. First off being the legal issue of getting custody of Gage, which should be no problem, I am hoping. But that is going to cost money. The 7-year-old now has to readjust his life and move to his grandmother's home and also need extensive counseling, according to Fiedelberg. Gage is going to have to attend a new school, make new friends, which he has already told me he does not want to do, she wrote. The 7-year-old was at the Rancho Tehama Elementary School on Tuesday when the gunfire broke out and teachers told students to hide under their desks. Randy Morehouse, the district's maintenance and operations head, said Neil tried and tried and tried and tried to get into the kindergarten door where Gage was, but it was locked. In an interview with KCRA-TV, the 7-year-old believes Neil targeted his school to try to find him. His grandmother said the gunman had an ongoing dispute with Gage's family, but was unclear of the details. Earlier this year, Neil was arrested and charged with stabbing Gage's father's girlfriend, Haile Suzanne Poland, and attacking her mother during a jam. .31 encounter in their rural neighborhood, according to court records. Poland filed for a civil restraining order a week later, protecting herself and her mother and father-in-law, ages 68 and 74, as well as Gabe and his dad, Danny Elliott, 38, according to the records obtained by the Los Angeles Times. Poland wrote in the plea to a judge that Neil is very unpredictable and unstable. Has anger issues and threatened the household with a gun. She also said her and her family lived in fear of him because he was violent and unpredictable, firing off guns at all hours and threatening her with all kinds of perverted things. Without naming her, sheriff's officials said Wednesday that the woman seeking the protective order was killed by Neil. Ashraf's deputy on April 1 handed Neil a court order to stay away from Poland and her family and barred him from possessing guns. Records show Neil certified that he surrendered his weapons in February, but Tehama County Assistant Sheriff Phil Johnston said Wednesday authorities had recovered 2 illegal homemade assault rifles and 2 handguns registered to someone else. At Wednesday's news conference, Johnston initially said Neil was not prohibited from owning firearms, but later acknowledged the protective order against him. After being pressed by reporters on why police did not act when Neil was in clear violation of his court order, Johnston replied, "The law is only for people who obey it."The gunman's sister, Sheridan Orr, said her brother had struggled with mental illness throughout his life and at times had a violent temper, adding that he had no business owning firearms. Several other neighbors had repeatedly reported that Neil was firing hundreds of rounds at his property every night. "The guy was a bad guy. I mean really just a bad person. Some people are just bad," he said. When asked by Fox 40 if the rampage was a shock, Sanders said he told them this was coming. When asked further what he meant, Sanders said Neil told them we would all pay, that we would be the ones to pay in the end.